I'm Phil Harvey, and this is Light Reading Goes to Hollywood. We're here in Los Angeles, California, to see the Walt Disney Studios StudioLAB. But why are we here at the Griffith Observatory? It's because a lot of what we saw today we can't actually show you, but it is the future of communications. This is new types of content being distributed on new networks at lightning fast speed. This is all about the future of communications. Here's what we saw today. One of the things they're doing is using augmented reality to wrap public spaces inside of content. So you can feel like you're inside the movie. Another thing they're doing that's interesting is rendering animation on site at Disney Studios, using the cloud to distribute it all over the world. And in the process, they're looking forward to 5G networks because they can take that content, get collaboration on it in real time. They're using drone technology to do 3D maps of locations so they don't have to spend days combing the ground personally. Instead, they can fly over and do a 3D map, and it's safer and quicker than ever before. It's an interesting time too because the stakes for Disney have never been higher. They're about to launch a direct-to-consumer streaming service to compete with Netflix and hundreds of other streaming services. And one of the things that Walt Disney Studios is trying to do is look out 3 to 5 years and see how people are going to consume content next. But in the meantime, they can make incremental changes to their workflow and their technology processes and see some of those results right now. This is really talking about how DevOps is taking over the studio system in the same way that it has the technology universe. It's an incremental approach, and it's really interesting because this is where content is going.
Is this more of a studio or more of a lab?
I think it's kind of the best of both worlds, right? Because it's actually a lab on the historic studio lot. And so I think both words really have a lot of power. And when you bring them together, I think it really describes who we are and what we do.
You get the sense from talking to Ben Havey that executives from all over the Walt Disney Studio system have buy-in on the studio lab.
Production is this really complex process that involves lots of moving pieces, and to whatever degree we can provide technology that allows groups to work together in a more harmonious way, in a more collaborative way, you know, we're creating value for the company.
In addition to all of that, we saw some really good use cases for collaboration tools from Cisco.
The last 3 years, Phil, we've been really investing in media and entertainment solutions as part of Cisco's strategy for this segment.
We started with our Cisco Room Kit, which is becoming very popular very quickly. It's an easy way to go ahead and collaborate via audio and video at a one-touch deployment. The second piece has been on our new WebEx boards, and that we see as collaboration of the future, especially when it comes to content collaboration. So not only will we be able to connect via audio and video, but we're talking about sometime in the future going ahead and collaborating with actual real live data at the time and actually going ahead and modifying it together as two companies, no matter where you could be in the world.
It's been fascinating to understand how creative people like to collaborate. That's really been interesting, and they're helping guide us with that, that roadmap and where what they would like to do with this.
With 5G networks right around the corner, that's obviously a push to use technology in different ways. What technologies are most important here at the Studio Lab?
With 5G, not only are you going to get super fast downstream, so that's going to make the ability to consume big experiences, because we think video is a bandwidth hog. The kind of experiences we're talking about are, game engine quality or better. So just the ability to deliver these experiences out to consumers, but also the low latency, right? That participatory aspect of kind of this future vision that we have means that people are in the world and they're talking to other people and they're communicating in real time, and the low latency nature of 5G I think will really help. Or even a step further, think about a 5G connected camera that could potentially shoot right to the cloud. These are all things that I think are coming and will only help our business.
Disney's a content powerhouse, and they don't necessarily have to own the last mile. When they were an animation house, they didn't own the movie theater. When they bought Capital Cities and ESPN, they didn't own the cable companies that actually broadcast the signals into consumers' homes. Very similarly, they don't own the last mile, the telecom network, the 5G network, that's going to be carrying their new direct-to-consumer streaming service. So it is direct-to-consumer, but Disney doesn't own that last mile. They never have. They stick to what they do well, and everyone partners with them. Why? Because they're Disney.